A complete predicate consists of both the verb of a sentence and the words around it, the words that modify the verb and complete its meaning. So in this sentence, he is the subject. And so I'm going to put one line under it. And ran is the verb of the sentence. So he ran a long way. So just a simple predicate would just be the verb right here, ran. But we're looking for a complete predicate here. So a complete predicate is going to be all the sentences that modify and further describe the verb. So, ran a long way is the complete predicate in this sentence. Generally, all the words that come after the verb are going to be part of the predicate. So, you see right here, the subject's right here, then the verb. So, all these words past the verb is going to be part of the predicate. That's not always true, but generally, you can determine the predicate that way. This next sentence says, the elderly mayor retired yesterday. So mayor is the subject, so I'll put one line under that word, and retired is the verb. So yesterday right here is also part of the predicate. So the complete predicate would be retired yesterday. Now the reason yesterday is part of the predicate is because I said that any words that modify the verb or further describe the verb are part of the predicate. Well, yesterday is what we call an adverb, which is a word that modifies the verb, because yesterday is telling when the mayor retired. So yesterday further explains the verb retired. So that's why yesterday is part of the predicate. So retired yesterday would be the complete predicate of that sentence. This last example says, I wrote a paper last night and turned it in this morning. Well, the sentence looks kind of complicated when determining the predicate, but it's actually pretty easy. I is the subject. Now the verb right here is going to be wrote. So the complete predicate is going to be wrote a paper last night. Now, and right here is what we call a conjunction because it joins two parts of a sentence together. But right after and we see another verb, which is turned. Turned is a verb. So turned it in this morning is also going to be the complete predicate. So right here, we see a subject, two complete predicates joined together by a conjunction. So sometimes sentences are going to have two complete predicates. So the important thing to remember here is that a complete predicate consists of the verb and any words that modify or further explain the verb.